Good evening and welcome back to our question and answer series for Anash.org. Question: what is the reason and source we don't listen to music during Sfira? And is it permitted to listen to music in some situations? The makar of not listening to music in the Sfira is in Shulchan Aruch, Siman Tuf Tzadik Gimel, Sif Aleph. The Mechaber writes that the minig is that Yaron get married from Pesach till Shavuos, because in that time the students of Rabbi Akiva died. He had 24,000 students and all died in this specific time. So therefore, Mitzad Avaylas, the minig is that you shouldn't get married between Pesach and Shavuos. And the Mechaber writes that's only getting married, but getting engaged is not a problem. So the Mung of Rom writes on the Shulchan Aruch what the Mechaber says, that you could get engaged between in the Sfira days, that's only you could get engaged, but when you make a shidduch, you cannot make rikidim and mecholas. So the Mung of Rom learned that the reason why you cannot marry in between Pesach and Shavuos is because the nekidus ha'iser is because the dancing, rikidim and mecholas. And since by chasana, the ikas simchas chasana, the main thing of the chasana is the dancing, so therefore, he writes, not only you cannot make chasana between Pesach and Shavuos, you could also not make dancing if you made a shidduch. So basically, the Mungan of Rome already comes down with such a thing as that you shouldn't make anything dancing in the Yemaya Sfira. But it doesn't say anything about listening to music. The Prima Gudam in Sima Kituf Kivnin Aleph, that's in the Hilchas Bainam Tzorim, the 3 weeks, he says already that the halachas of listening to music has the same halachas as Rekidim and Mecholis, as dancing. So whenever it's also to make dancing, Rekidim and Mecholis, it is also also to listen to music, to play music. Because he writes over there, what the Magen Avraham writes over there, that you cannot make Rekidim and Mecholos in the 3 weeks from Shavuos B'Tammuz till after Tisha B'Av. So the Prima Gurim writes that a person which his panosa is to sing with Klei Zemer by non-Jewish affairs, since it's his panosa, he could play music, because that's like a dover ovet, and you could play music. So we see already he connected it, that whenever it's also the kidma mecholas, it's also usher to play music, listen to music. So since over here in Yemei Sfira, the Mungan Avraham writes that you cannot have Rekidim HaMecholos, and he learned it from the Shulchan Aruch, which says you shouldn't get married in the Yemaya Sfira. So according to the Prima Gudam, you cannot listen to music or play music in the Yemaya Sfira. But the question is there any situation that you could be a Michael? The Poskim say that a person which needs it very much for his health, that means he has depression or this kind of things, that he must listen, whenever he listens to music, it calms down. But it's not every person, it's a person which has deeply medical problems, so he could have a heter to listen to music. Or a person, let's say, for instance, is driving and he's very tired, and he's afraid that he will fall asleep, then he could listen to music and classical music, because classical music also, we could say, does not go into the gather of klezmer, which has a shaykhs with rikim mecholos, because rikim mecholos basically is an Indian of dancing. So when it goes to lively music, so that we could say it has a shaykhs to rikim mecholos. But when you have classic music, in a matzav when you need it for health reasons, or a person shouldn't fall asleep in the middle of driving, he could be Michael classic music. But in any case, today's day that you could buy tapes, vocal tapes, which doesn't have music at all, it is kedai not to go into this heter and use vocal musical tapes and not real music tapes. Question: this year we're like Boimer Falls on a Friday. Is there any heter to play music by a Chabad House event Thursday before like Boimer, before the Shkia? Again, as we just mentioned, live music or even lively music like Boimer during the day Thursday, it's not a heter. But I think that from the Shkia you could be Michael on music, even live music, because after all it's a Issa Drabonan, and once it gets the Shkia it's a Sofik Drabonan, it's a Sofik, maybe it's already night. So by Sofik Drabonan, and it's also the Tzorich Mitzvah, we could be Michael from the Shkia to hear regular music, even lively music. But if in a way that the event has to start a little bit earlier, I think if it's not in a frum community and it's not in a marazai, in a mayomri abrias, and it's indoor, then I think you could have music playing already, at least classical music, negine zvadas, slow music, even earlier before the Shkia. So to sum it up, from the Shkia you could have regular music, even lively music. Before the Shkia, I would say once it started already after Mincha, when in its role they play already music, at least we could Michael Negine Zvadas, classic music, and then after, first should be the speeches and the other program, and then when it comes to the Shkia, you could start regular music. This is what I feel, how you should go about it. Would it make a different recorded music? No, it will be the same as regular music. Question. My wife always makes Pesach Shaini, Chremzlich, and Kneidlich from Pesach Matzah Mehl. Can I eat the Kneidlich and the Chremzlich even without washing, or I have to wash to bread or to matzah, and only then I can eat the Chremzlich and Kneidlich? This question is a good question. Alter Rebbe speaks about it in Seider Berchus and Hanem, Pairik Bais, Halacha Tezvov. Alter Rebbe writes like this: when you take a bread, and the same will be also to a matzah, and you break it down, you make it crumbs, and then you stick it together through honey or milk or other kind of eggs, and it becomes like a dough, it becomes like a isa, and it doesn't have a look like baked bread. The bracha is boiri min mazoinas and al hamichyu, since it didn't have all the small pieces, you broke it down, it shouldn't have, every piece should be less than a kezayis, and it does not have a toyer lechem, that means it doesn't look like bread or like matzah. And Alter Rebbe writes, therefore, according to the meaning that we do, we take matzah and you break it down to tiny pieces, and then you make it with hot water and oil and eggs, and you make it knaidlich chremslich. This is how he brings it down, knaidlich chremslich, and it doesn't have a look like bread. The bracha is boirimir mazoinus and ala mechiu. And even though it was not cooked afterwards, it's only fried afterwards, then it is only a mezoinus. The Alter Rebbe puts it, he stresses it, because when it comes to, if you cook it afterwards, everybody holds it's a mezoinus. But if you fry it, some poskim say that frying is the same halacha as baking, and when you bake it, then goes into a different category, it might be a moitzi. So let's sum up the halacha. Kneidlich. First, let's talk about kneidlich. Kneidlich is a thing which you cook. You make, you mish a whole together with all kind of things, water and eggs, and then you cook it. Since you cook it, the bracha is boirimin mazoinus and halamechiu, even if the water is more, is roiv, more than the maipires, than the eggs. And even if you're going to eat a lot, more than kviya sida, that means more than four, the size of four eggs, it's still going to be a mazoinus, because it gets considered as if it is a farina or Quaker's oat, which is also mazoinus, and as much as you're going to eat, it's still going to stay a mazoinus, and it's still, you're going to make alamechiu. So when you take kneidlich, even though it's made with water and a lot of water, since you cook it afterwards, it is always going to be a mazoinus and alamechiu, and it doesn't matter how much you're going to eat. That's kneidlich. When it comes to chremslich, that's a little bit different, because chremslich, you don't cook, you only fry it. So therefore, if it's made with roiv, is oil and eggs, then the bracha is mezoinus and alamechiu. If the bracha is, if most of the things which is going, the water is more than the eggs and the oil, if you eat less than dalal baitzam, then you're going to make a mezoinus and alamechiu. But if you're going to eat more than dalal baitzam, then you have to make a moitzi merchamuzin. So again, chremslach, since it's not cooked, it's only fried. If the roif is from eggs and oil, it's always alamechiu and boirimin mezoinus. If roif is from water, then it depends. If you eat less than dalat baitzam, then the broch is mezoinus and alamechiu. If you eat more than dalat baitzam, then you're going to make hamoitzi and berchsamosn. But that's chremzlich which you fry. If someone makes chremzlich by baking it, so then if the roiv is from eggs and oil, then if you eat less than dalat baitzam, it's a mezoinus and alamechiu. And if most of the, that means the roiv is water, in any case it's hamoitzi. Even if you ask a tiny drop, because now you didn't fry it, you baked it. And by baking it, it has a din as if it's a piece of cake, so to speak. So if it's roiv, oil and eggs, has a din like cake. And it depends if you eat less than dalat baitzam or you eat more than dalat baitzam. But if most of the liquid over there is water, and it's more than the oil and the and the eggs, then since you are baking it and not frying it, even if you eat a tiny drop, you should wash and make bergersamusen. Follow-up question from last week. Last week you spoke about the bracha on schnitzel, breaded cutlets, and you said that the breaded cutlets, it is according to the Alter Rebbe, it is a berachas hamazoynes. But since there is a suffix, you should make a bracha on something else, etc. Now the question is: is this only breaded crumbs, which is you bought in the store, or even breaded crumbs, breadcrumbs, which is made from my leftover challah, or taking Pesach matzah and crushing it and making breadcrumbs, and then you make breaded cutlets, is it still amazonas, or then it might be hamoitzi? This is a very good question, and let me just explain the question. Usually when you buy breadcrumbs in the store, it is made from bread which was baked special to make from that crumbs. So l'chol adayis, according to all the poskim, it is amazonas, because it was baked l'ketchila in order to make breadcrumbs. But the question here is, if you take your leftover challah or your matzah and you grind it, you make breadcrumbs. Now breadcrumbs, as it is, from when you take a challah and you make it crumbs, it is a moitzi. As the Alter Rebbe writes in Seider Berachas Hanhanim, Pirek Bais Sifi Dalet, that when you take a bread and you eat a tiny piece, a breadcrumb, even it's as tiny as kemach, as flour, and it doesn't look like bread when you look it through the eyes because it's so tiny, even though it's so tiny, it is still hamoitzi, and you eat a shir of a gezayis, you have to bench berachas hamuzen. So the question is, when you take these tiny crumbs, which was once a challah or a matzah, and you broke it up, so once you break it up, it's still a hamoitzi. If I make breaded cutlets, schnitzel, if now it's still hamoitzi and I have to wash in order to eat these breaded crumbs, or amazonis will be enough. And the answer to this is like this. The Alter Rebbe says, a bread which was baked, and afterwards you cook it in a pot with water, the cooking does not take it out from being a bread, and it doesn't change the bracha from hamoitzi to mazoinos. Only if you soaked it in water and it gets nimcha, that means it changed the consistency, it gets dissolved, then it doesn't look like bread, and it is dissolved, then it becomes a berachas hamazoinos and no more berachas hamoitzi. That's when you cook it. If you fry it, zog d'Alter Rebbe, you have to be machmer. So if a person takes bread and he doesn't cook it afterwards, he fries it afterwards, then you have to be machmer, and that it stays hamoitzi. So when you take these crumbs and you put it on top of the cutlet, maybe it is hamoitzi. In the Tzemach Tzedek writes in the Chedishim, Daft Kif Tzadik has, that even if you eat less than Kviyas Shir, as I mentioned before, the amount of eating 4 eggs, you still cannot eat it only b'tar chasida, only when you wash. So the question goes, is this kotlet tamoitzi? And the answer is no. Because after all, when you make kotlets, you put on top of it eggs, and then you put in on top of it the crumbs. So when you have the crumbs together with the eggs and with frying it with the oil, then it gets already like some kind of dough, and it doesn't have the looks of bread, and that's therefore it becomes a mazoinus, like as we mentioned previous, like kneidlich. That means a breaded cutlet, it becomes like a whole cover on top of it. It's not just crumbs on top of the cutlet. It becomes like a dough which covers the cutlet. And therefore, since it became like a dough and it changed the toyer lechem because it was already fried together with eggs and oil, so therefore it is changing the bracha from hamazoinus, from hamoiti to mazoinus. Question. You don't make a shechiyanu, a new fruit, if there is available in the grocery the entire year. However, I have a mango tree growing in my backyard, which is much better in taste than the mango sold in grocery. Can I make a shechiyanu on that fruit? The answer is no. Since it is the same mean as the, it's all a mango, although yours might be better in taste, but the mean, this family of mangoes, you could buy all year round, so therefore you cannot make a shechiyanu, even if you have a mango which tastes different and much better than the regular mangoes. Okay, we're going to stop here. Thank you for joining us, and please join us next week again, and send in your questions to inbox@anash.org. Good night, and have a wonderful week, and a wonderful Lag Boimer.